So far, error handling has come in the form of dot catches like this one, but there are actually other ways. These two chunks of code are actually equivalent. Dot catch is just shorthand for dot then undefined and then a rejection function. Notice how this then actually is taking two arguments. The full function signature for then is actually this. In this form, if any previous promise is rejected, the reject function gets called. If they resolve, then the resolve function gets called. If there is no resolve function, and the promise before this then resolves, then this then gets skipped over, and the next then is called. In all cases, as soon as a promise rejects, then the JavaScript engine skips to the next reject function in the chain, whether that's in a dot catch or a dot then. So that means an error here in this promise or here in this promise both get caught by this catch. Both methods, .catch and .then with two callbacks, work equally well. However, it's actually recommended that you use .catch when you can, because .catch is just easier to read and write than a second .then callback, which can be hard to spot. In fact, you might not have even noticed it right here. That being said, there is a major difference in the execution order between .catch and a second callback. Notice that you cannot call both the resolve function and the reject function if they're part of the same dot then. Only one or the other or neither will get called. If something goes wrong with the resolve function, you'll need another dot catch or another dot then farther down the line to catch it. But if you have dot then and then a dot catch, each with their own resolve or reject function, both of them can possibly get called. And finally, I want to make one more subtle point. It's also worth noting that it isn't necessarily true that passing a value to resolve means that the promise succeeded. This is a subtle point, so go see Jake Archibald's blog post in the instructor notes for more information. In the next quiz, you'll be thinking through the flow of a chain of promises using different formats.